I pozdrav svima, evo nas treći dan, nalazimo se u predsetu, kao što možete vidite, kolege neke jedu, neke rade, mi smo još da snimimo, se zove najuzdanašnji dan, prvo ćemo se pozabaviti danom koji je iza nas, svi koji ste juče gledali SL Major znate da se desilo nevjerojatno čudo, Navi nije prošao u finale, to ćemo malo kasnije, ajde prvo se pozabavimo mečom MIBR Astralis, znači to je meč koji je bio poprilično, očekivu se da će biti relativno lak meč, da će ono kao MIBR da ispadne brzo. I činjenično stanje da je na prvoj mapi MIBR pužio fantastičan otpor. Znači igrao sa Overpass, Astralis je uspio da pobedi 16-14. Bukvalno su se lomili do posljednjeg momenta. Momci iz MIBR su stvarno igrali srčano. Tu nije bilo ono kao priča, ali taj zadnje runde su bile jako nesretne za njih. Par ono kao ovih se zove čistih poteza su promašili i mislim da ih je to dekoncentrisalo. Jer posle toga Inferno, Astralis se pokazuje zašto je Astralis, zašto samo uzima turnir u zadnjih godinu dana i ovih se zove deklasiraju ih je sa 16-7. Ali ono o čemu želimo da pričamo je meč Navi Ence. Znači ja ne mogu da vam opišem koliko je to bilo uzbudljivo gledati. Znači ja Counter nisam dugo vremena igrao, pratim ga ovako, ponovo sam dobio želju da ga kući instaliram i da igram. Znači, prva mapa, Train, NC je pobedio 6-14. Fantastične partije, nevjerovatni raševi, znači eko partije koje su ono bile nevjerovatne, znači ono, pomislite kod ljudi imaju eko partiju, ne mogu ništa da urade, oni dobiju, mislim, bilo nevjerovatno. Pa onda druga mapa, druga mapa je na Dust 2, je palo gaženje, znači to što je to što je Navi uradio sa Zvezdom na drugoj mapi, to je bilo neverovatno. Znači, ja sam bukvalno mislio da su ih uništili. 16-3. Simple je pogodio takve stvari na Dust 2, kakve ja u životu nisam video. Znači, bukvalno, čovjek ni ne vidi, već je mrtav, ono kao Simple ga je ubio sa snajperom. I onda je došla treća mapa, to je bio Miraž. NC je gubio i onda su dobili 7 rundi za redom. 7 rundi za redom. I tu su prelomili Navi i dobili su 16-14. I sada su u finalu. Danas čekamo, znači, finale, ovi se zove NC protiv Astralisa, Astralis je naravno favorit. Svaka dva takmiči se takođe završava, Fortnite je ovi se zove takođe završen, znači sve se lagano danas završava. Danas ćemo vidjeti ko će biti šampioni u tim svim disciplinama. A juče smo imali priliku da pričamo sa pobednicama ženskog turnira, Timon Dignitas. Eto, toliko od nas se zove za ovo javljanje i večeras, naravno, čućete odjavu. Pravilima svakog ESL Majora je da svaki tim mora dođe na konferenciju za novinare. Ne moraju pričati sa novinarima s kojima ne žele, ali moraju dođe na konferenciju za novinare. Tim Liquid koji je juče izgubio se pojavio ovde, jer što je morao da ne bi dobili penale i ćutali su sve vreme. To je po meni jedan jako nezrao potez. Pod jedan, nijedan novinar ovde nije želao da ih nešto pita bezobrazno ili maltretira. Da smo još želi da uzme izjave od njih. Oni su time pokazali svoj protest. Čime? To što ne znam igraju Counter-Strike. To nije naš problem, to je njihov problem. Mi smo imali intervju sa kapitanom tima Dignitas, koji su, se zove, affiliate za Philadelphia 76ers, koji su stacionirani u Atlanti. Čuli ste, ako budete gledali taj intervju, čućete da su oni bili ono kao u Atlanti 7 dana u bootcampu, da su radili sa psihijatrima, sa psiholozima, sa ljudima koji su zaduženi za medije. Ona je devojka ovde briljirala. Bila je nasmejana, bila je jednostavno devojka puna ono kao razumevanje, odradila je svoj posao korektno. Team Liquid i ljudi kao što su Team Liquid koji smatruju dovoljno dobro igraju Counter-Strike i da je to sve što je potrebno, nikad neće biti pravi e-sportisti.
First of all, which match was harder, finals or against the Serral?
물론 잘하는 상대지만 편하게 했고 그래도 아무래도 결승에서 많이 졌다 보니까 김대엽 선수가 가장 어려웠던 것 같습니다.
So in major tournaments, I actually never was out in round of 8. So even though Serral is a really good player, I was more scared of stats because you know I've been losing a lot in the finals.
With stats start to lead 2-0. What was his feeling? Did he feel that he can come back And how did he feel when he made an equalize when he it was 2-2?
아, 김대혁 선수가 2대0으로 앞서가는 순간에 어떤 생각이 들던가요? 그리고 다시 2대1로 동점을 만들었을 때 어땠나요?
처음에 2대0으로 지고 있을 때는 그냥 오늘도 그냥 또 준우승 하는구나 그냥 또 이런 생각을 가졌는데 2대2 되는 순간 이거 혹시라는 생각이 들었는데 괜히 그런 생각 들면은 또 질 것 같아서 그냥 최대한 마음가짐을 편하게 했어요.
So when I was down 0-2, I just thought, oh well, I'm going to be second again today. But like when I equalized the score 2-2, I was like, hey, maybe I could win this time. But you know, like I wanted to not to think too much about it because I wanted to stay focused in the game. So I just stayed and played the game.
And does he think can he win GSL or BlizzCon?
GSL이나 BlizzCon 우승 가능하시다고 보나요?
항상 불가능하다고 생각해왔는데 오늘 이후로는 생각이 바뀔 것 같습니다.
So I've always thought it would be impossible, but after today, my mind changed.
Thank you very much. I evo nas u Katovicama, malo smo izašli, ja i Peđa da prošetamo, pošto sada imamo pauzu od jedno 2-3 sata prema što počne finale CSGO turnira. Ono što vas može interesovati definitivno je da je StarCraft 2 turnir završen, pobednik je SO koji je od 2-0 uspeo da pobedi 5-2 i time prekinuo losing streak koji je bio popravičan. Vidjet ćemo da li će biti tako interesantno i CSGO finale i da li će Astralis biti bolji od NC-a ili će NC uspjeti napravi najveće iznenađenje na ovom turniru i eliminiše apsolutne favorite. Mislim će naše posljednje javljanje biti iz arene, gde ćemo pokušati da dobijemo i intervju od pobednika CSGO turnira.
Thank you. Aleksandar Rašković, Level IT. Do you think that if you played Navi in the finals, the games would be much tougher, maybe interesting? And do you think, would you want also?
I think that Innis fully deserved to be here. I think everyone can be, and especially themselves, can be very proud of how they performed throughout this whole thing. Not just the playoffs, but also the group stage and the minor and everything they went through. They've definitely shown that talent and some experienced players can definitely bring back good stuff. And I think they should be really proud of themselves because they played a really amazing train, and we have actually quite impressed with them. So, I mean, I don't think it would have been looking that much different on Navi. Like, we have a good idea how Navi plays as well. I think that's also why we are playing that well. We have a good understanding of how to approach these teams. But I'm actually happy for Ennis and for everyone that they made it here, because I think they feel deserved, and they achieved a lot more than anyone has ever expected.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. Phelps told me this afternoon that Astralis were not invincible. So, what's your opinion? Are you invincible or not?
Phelps. Well, you can ask him yesterday. No. Of course, we're not invincible. That would be even more amazing than what we've just done. It's always hard to answer these questions. We've lost at iBuy Power Masters. We've lost last year. I think that some of the losses actually define us as persons, and how we manage to get through that and work through as a unit is what makes us this good. So, no one is invincible, and we're just hoping to get a good match against them in some part.
Thank you.
Yes, please.
Yeah, so my question is for Glebe. I'm Anna. I work with the draft right now, the Brazilian outlet. So during that period where Taco tweeted about the smoke bug, and everybody made the jokes about how Astralis needed to change their game, that's all over the internet. It was all over on Twitter. How did we react to that? Did you took that seriously, or did you just joke it around too? What was your reaction? Did actually click on any of your strategy? What happened back then?
I think we took it a bit of a joke. I think it was nice of people to actually believe that it would actually change the game for us, because we just showed everyone that just fixing a bug or something that we didn't even use that much is not going to help the other team's beaters. So I think the other team need to do something else. I don't think Valve will fix it for them.
Thank you very much, Liv.
Paul from MG, congratulations for win. What was the strongest team here in Katowice and why?
I think if you should say it before the tournament started, I think I would say Liquid. But now I'm having a tough time saying what is the strongest team that has been here besides us. I think maybe a team like MIBR has huge potential to go and be a really good team. They showed it with Tarek and Stewie, and we played some amazing finals against them in the later half of last year. And I hope that and I believe that they will come back and be a really great team. And I just think they need a bit more time.
VP Esports, okay. So guys, which matchup for you was tougher, against MIBR or today against NC?
I think it was tougher yesterday, but I guess I base it on the hard move last game. It was really tough and it was very mental and draining. But I mean, NC did play great today on the first map, second map was that good maybe, but yeah, I mean, they showed potential in this tournament, and I think Ents will go far in the other tournaments.
Can I ask another?
Michael, I would like to ask, how do you consider your toughest future opponent?
Yeah, I think, as said before, I think it's probably going to be Liquid and MIBR if they get some more time together.
Okay, four more questions, guys.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, from Mizy Sports. My question is for Dupri. Dupri, playing a tournament after a loss has to be really hard. What made you so strong and keep it playing?
The thing is that obviously losing my father was really tough, and I had a really big doubt with myself whether to go here or not. But he made sure, like basically the last thing he said to me is that he wanted me to go here. And coming here, being with my team, and being around the persons that I share the most with in my life has definitely helped me through this. And having a talk with all the people back home, like my family and everything. And I guess like the fact that you go to a place where you know you can perform, and the place where you're most successful in life will definitely help you. And then all the comments and all the love that I've gotten from other players or stuff like that has definitely helped me. So. Yeah, I'm just happy that I fulfilled my father's wish.
Kraj. Završen je turnir. Ove se zove fantastične partije smo gledali tokom celog turnira na kraju Astralis Ants na D trainu, neverovatna borba 16-14. Nažalost, D Inferno Ants nije imao snage. Deklasirao ih je, ovaj, se zove Astralis. Upravo su sad imali konferenciju na novinare. Oni su bili prilično velikodušni prema svojim protivnicima. Rekli su da je Astralis zasluženo bio u finalu, da su oni generalno gledano jako dobro odigrali, da su oni odigrali bolje, pošto tajna njihova uspeha je u tome što većinom jako dobro znaju kako protivnici igraju i zajedno se im prelagode. Fantastičan SL Major. Celo Katovice je bilo u znaku SL Major, što mogli sami da vidite. Preko milion ljudi je pratilo ovih sezona streamove. Ja iskreno nemam više šta da dodam. Nama je vreme, krenemo za Beograd. Bilo mi je pravo zadovoljstvo što sam bio jednog ovakvog događaja. Vidimo se uskoro na nekom novom turniru. Ćao!